strikes again, right?
Yeah. Everything's pretty different since the pandemic. Mm.
Thank you.
Let's try that again. Your response is, Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia, alleluia, Christ is risen. Amen. We welcome all those who are with us this morning in worship. We welcome those who are worshiping with us online. We are grateful to be in this place gathered in this glorious Easter morning. Grateful to be on the land, the traditional land of the Mohawk and Mohican people. And grateful for all those who are participating in our worship, our brass, our choir, those making audio and visual video possible, those sharing in our children's ministry downstairs following worship. It is great to be here this day. And the beauty that bedecks this place, we are so grateful to Gay Doolittle and the Chancel Guild that made this possible. We need your help in bringing this beauty to those people who are not able to join us or have been recently bereaved this past year. Following worship, there's an opportunity to help spread this Easter joy and beauty. There are cards lined up on the front pew railing there. If you're able to help deliver some of these flowers to those who are in need of that joy and that beauty following worship, please come up and grab a card and then get a flower, and Chancel Guild members will help you, assist you in any way you need that. Also, following worship today, there's a feast that awaits us in the reception, Eastertide reception in Covenant Hall. I encourage anyone who wishes to join us there for that time. And I believe there may be an egg hunt for those who are young of age, not young of heart. If you're young of heart and wanna participate in that, you can do so visually. You can line up and watch that egg hunt happen. I believe it's going to be out in the garden area, the courtyard, Memorial Courtyard area. Yep, out that way, following worship and that reception. It is a great day. It is a beautiful day. It is the joy of the resurrection that we celebrate together. It is our joy. The risen Christ has come among us.
Next week, Daniel will be preaching as his last week before sabbatical. He leaves on the 16th after service. He goes on sabbatical for, 14 years. I don't know, 4 months? 4 months? 4 months? 4 months. I would love us all to be here to wish him well. Palm and olive bough may fling. I mean, whatever. But just so you know, we'll miss you. And please take the opportunity to come and see Daniel off for his 4 months. As I'll be the guy weeping and moaning and rending my garments back in the office. Lots of things coming up in the next few months that are really awesome. We're going to be doing Earth Day stuff on April 22nd. We'll be doing Crop Walk on May 7th. So we are partaking in the larger community, helping clean up and taking good care of our systems around here. So please keep aware of all these announcements that will be coming up about Earth Day and Crop Walk and everything else to follow. Anything else?
I don't think so.
Okay. Please join in our call to worship as found in the bulletin. Jesus is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Praise God who rescues us from darkness.
God redeems us and turns our weeping to tears of joy.
Praise be our risen Savior,
who is the firstborn of all creation and makes all things new.
Praise be to God who, through love, with love, and in love, calls us to love.
We come with understand the one who is love.
Jesus is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Jesus Christ is risen today. Alleluia.
We share together the truth of our lives. Being sinners, we call upon God, who is merciful, loving, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love. Let us share together our prayer, our need for God, as found in the bulletin. Let us pray. Almighty God, in raising Jesus from the tomb, you have given us the sure sign of your power to deliver us from sin and death and to renew our whole creation. We confess that we still fall into doubt and fear. We continue to cling to selfish ways and doubt your power to make all things new. Forgive our lack of faith. Have mercy on our weakness. Raise us from the death of sin, that we may live with Christ in the joy of his resurrection, now and forever. Friends, receive this good news. Our risen Lord has rescued us in all holiness. Our eternal and almighty God has loved us and has sent God's only Son into the world for our forgiveness, for our reconciliation. So let us receive God's love. Let us receive the hope of Christ embodied, and let us receive the Spirit's sanctifying power in our lives. Let us respond in praise to this good and gracious God, singing the fourth stanza once again of Jesus Christ is Risen Today. Affirmation of faith is in the form of a prayer. Let us share together that affirmation. Glorious Lord of life, by the mighty resurrection of your Son, you overcame the old order of sin and death to make all things new in him. Grant that we who profess our faith in your word, who celebrate with joy Christ rising from the dead, may be raised from the death of sin to the life of righteousness that Jesus' resurrection promises, through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The peace of Christ Jesus be with you. Share a word or sign of Christ's peace with one another now.
May I please have all the children forward? Hello. Hi. Oh, I thought there were toys for them to play with. Have a seat. So our communications specialist told us yesterday or the day before that, how you doing? Love the coat. Honey, can I borrow that? That's so me. All right, yeah, I guess we'll sit on the floor. What do you think? We can sit on the floor. Yeah. Not going to hurt anybody, right? Yeah. No. My mic, not yours. You can borrow the floor, but not the mic. You may.
I do not know my friend Millie is coming to church, and she's walking. Me and her are in the same place.
I'm almost as excited that Millie's here. Yeah. Almost. Yeah, Millie, welcome.
Go.
Okay, so. Let's get to work so you guys can have some fun and then go downstairs and then later on you can have your Easter egg hunt. Yes.
I just want it now.
We are in church. We are in church. And so, whatever works, right? So here's the deal. Do you know where Jesus was the last thing he did before he went to the cross? Do you know where he was, where he hung to pray? No, before that, where he went to pray, where?
With his friends.
With his friends to a garden. He went to a garden. And do you know where the first place one of his friends saw him after he was raised from the dead?
Yeah.
Where was that?
At the mountain?
Nope. Guess again. In a garden.
A garden.
So Jesus, before he goes to the cross, and then after he's raised, hangs out in a garden. How many people here have a garden?
100.
All right, we all have gardens? I'll tell you about special places in the world where, like, your parents will tell you about someday. Like, there's this really cool festival in Maine called the Good Earth Festival. It's really very cool. And then there's one in Monticello called the Healthy Harvest Festival. It's all about... It does. It's all about gardening. Gardening. So what's the first story we know in the Bible about a garden? Has anybody ever heard of the Garden of Eden?
Yeah.
Can you tell me about the Garden of Eden?
Yes. So when Adam and Eve were in heaven, there's a snake, and that was Satan. And God said, don't eat the apple.
Uh-huh.
And then the snake told them to eat the apple, and they ate the apple.
Okay, so they're in the Garden of Eden before, when everything first started off, this really great story. And what was the Garden of Eden like? What words would you use?
Apple.
Was it... What do you think the adults know this answer?
Yeah, no.
What was the Garden of Eden like, adults? They say it's perfect. Well, you know what? I think they're wrong. Do you know why the Garden of Eden wasn't perfect? Do you know why the Garden of Eden wasn't perfect?
Yeah.
Why? Because there were no children.
What?
You weren't there. That's why it wasn't perfect. It can't be perfect without children and without you. That's right, but no children were. So what makes the world so much better is not just living your life in comfort, but having children around to bring joy, children to teach wonderful things, children to actually help grow. And I think that's why Jesus chooses a garden, because it's all about growth. I am going to give you a present for Easter. And what I'm giving you are seeds. Oh, wait, relax. That's coming. Relax, pumpkin. All right. So I'm going to hand this. Where's Jamie? Is she? Oh, no, Natalie. I will give these to you. You can hand these out to the kids. They're all herbs. Now tell me, what's it take for seeds to grow? Water. What else? Time. You are smart. What else? Sun. What else?
Soil.
What else? Air. What else?
Yes.
Care. You have to take care of them. Love. Yes. So I'm giving you, for Easter, you're getting a bunch of herbs so that when Daddy cooks, you can give him some fresh thyme. And when Grandma comes over, you can make sure there's plenty of basil. And so there are all these herbs, and they're organically sourced for all you people out there. So you go have fun, go grow a garden, and have a great time. And remember, the Garden of Eden wasn't perfect because children were not there. And I am borrowing that coat. Oh, wait, here. That's for you. Ooh.
Our first lesson comes from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, beginning with verse 34. Let us listen for the word of the Lord. Then Peter began to speak to them. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel. Preaching peace by Jesus Christ, he is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. How he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciples set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. She wept. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white, sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God.'" Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them that he had said these things to her. The good news of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please pray with me. Gracious God, may you open our hearts and our minds, enlightening us with truth and light, that we may accept the good news of the risen Savior. Amen. In our different gospel texts, we have different versions of what is going on Easter. And we well know that the Mark text sort of leaves us hanging, you know, the tomb is empty. And then it's more developed in Matthew and Luke. But in John, as always, there's the corrective. I love John, this gospel writer, this beloved disciple. And what he does here is he shows real humor in this whole situation. He points out to us that he beats the old man running to the tomb. He gets what's going on when the old man doesn't, Peter. He does it with a sort of like joy, because he understands, although he doesn't understand in fullness, he understands because he loves. Love allows this beloved disciple to believe and accept in the resurrection. If we are ever in doubt of truth, maybe we need to take a page from John's gospel and approach it in love and in hope. But the real standout person in today's gospel is actually Mary Magdalene. Now, we don't hear much about her throughout this text. We hear a lot about Mary from Bethany, Lazarus' sister, and we hear about a couple other Marys, but Mary Magdalene specifically is someone we really don't hear much about. She doesn't take the premier space that Mary from Bethany does. Mary from Bethany, who anoints Jesus' feet. Mary of Bethany, who has chosen the better part. This Mary Magdalene character is actually rather new to the text. But she takes us to a place that is brilliant. In her loss, in her weeping. She comes across her risen Savior, and she behaves in a way that nobody else in Scripture behaves. When she is met with her risen Savior, she has no fear. The rest of the disciples are hiding away for weeks on end in an upper room in fear. She approaches Jesus, as far as she understands, dead Jesus, and she has no fear. She greets Jesus much like the Harry Potter stories. She greets death as an old friend. There's no fear. And why is that? It's not like she knows that she's never going to die, or that she's not going to suffer, or that she's not going to, you know, fill in any of the blanks. But she knows that now, that because Jesus has conquered the enemy of death, that there is potential and hope for the rest of us, herself included. And there is no room for fear when you approach anything with love. In this day and age, on this beautiful Easter morning where the sun is shining and these flowers smell so fantastic, I love hyacinths and lilies. In this beautiful Easter day, we are reminded of the hope that love brings. We're reminded of the love that hope brings. And we're reminded that Jesus has conquered sin and death, which doesn't mean that we'll never have to go through heartache or hardship, but we can do it now without fear, knowing that in the final end of things, we will be reunited with your God and my God, with your Father and my Father, and with the one who conquers sin and death, so it has no power forever. That is what we celebrate on Easter. That is why it's so joyful. Be like the beloved disciple. See truth in love. Be like Mary Magdalene and look at the hardships without fear. And then the rest will all fall into place in the long run, in the eternity with God, in the kingdom of heaven. Amen.
In the confidence of this good news, and in response to the grace that we have received, we are invited to give generously of our morning offering. We have designated our Easter offering, our special Easter offering, to those who continue to struggle in Ukraine, and that offering is given. It can be made out in a check and placed into the offering plate, and if you do use a check and want to designate that to our special Easter offering for Ukraine, please make a note of that in the memo line. If you simply wish to give a gift that would be received by the church and used for ministry locally and in other ways, don't use that designation, but if you do wish to designate it, make sure it says Easter Offering Ukraine. Now we will receive the morning offering and be blessed by the offertory that accompanies it.
Let us pray. Gracious God, your Son gifted us with life eternal through death on a cross and rising to everlasting life. We bring our gifts forward to share in this good news with great joy. We bring these gifts forward so that they may be used as Christ would teach us to use them, to feed the hungry, to clothe the naked, to help those who are imprisoned, to aid those who are under strife and torment. We will use these gifts as a sign of your love. Bless and approve these gifts so that they may be used to share with the whole world about the good news that death is conquered and Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. Amen.
We rejoice with those who rejoice, and we weep with those who weep. Our congregation is mindful, and we extend our consolation to the family of Miranda Rand. Miranda was a member of the classes of Schenectady. She was the most recent supervisor of this congregation during our search process, and was a dear and faithful servant in so many ways to so many churches in this area. Let us join together our hearts in prayer with thanksgiving. I invite you to pray with me. O glorious God of all grace, you who have brought this cosmos into existence, you who are beyond our thought and comprehension, yet humble yourself to us that we may glimpse your glory, that we may come to a understanding of the lavishness of your steadfast love revealed in this world of wonders, and most fully in the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ our Lord. We give you thanks for every manifestation of your love, for the beauty of creation, for the steadfastness of the rising of the sun, for the warming of this day, for the connections with family and friends, for the embrace of those who may yet be strangers, the welcome that we experience by the wonder of your Spirit. We pray this day, O gracious God, for all those who seek, your face, who seek your presence amidst their woes and sorrows and heartaches, amidst the violence and unrest in this world, amidst the uncertainty and doubt. O God, all those who seek, we pray that they may find you in ways that are mysterious, find you in ways that are mundane, but meaningful and merciful. We pray this day, O God, for all those who weep, those who have been bereaved this year or recently, those who have lost jobs, those who have lost partners, those who have lost family members, those who have lost abilities and capabilities. O God, in their tears, may they come to know your consolation, your presence, your comfort, the assurance that all is not lost, that you lose no one, that all find their life in you, and that one day we shall be restored, and this day we may know the hope of that restoration, that resurrection, that renewal of all things through Christ, in whom all things have been created. On this day, O God, we pray for those who keep your word, for those who keep in their hearts the joy that you have risen, Christ our Lord, the joy that nothing shall separate us from your love, those who keep hope and faith and love, those who keep to the virtues revealed in Christ, made manifest in your saints of old, and those saints yet alive and moving among us. We remember this day those who have died around this time of the year in years past, William Rickard and Isla DePauli, Duncan Merwerder, Anne Matthews, Madeline Young, Garfield Williamson, Susan E. Shepherd, and Robert Beadle. With thanksgiving, we remember them, O Lord, and those whose names we have noted and listed, those whose flowers bear remembrance of them this day, and those who are not named, but whom we hold in our hearts with thanksgiving for the way in which they have nourished and nurtured us in the faith of Jesus Christ, in the hope of a world renewed, in the love that has made us and saved us and shall finally sustain us unto eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord, in whose name we are bold to pray as he taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Oh,
Christ is risen. Alleluia. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Siblings in Christ, put things in order. Listen to Paul's appeal. Do not argue with one another. Live in peace, and the God of love and peace be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. Keep alert. Stand firm in your faith. Be courageous. Be strong. Have no fear. And let all that you do be done in love. And we ask this through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of Father and Spirit, one. Amen.